Hello, Meter Man, Joe Esposito. I'm from Owosso, Oklahoma, but we're actually in Tulsa, south of Owosso today. And today is November the 13th. And we are in North Tulsa, and we are west of McLean High School, about two blocks. And we're with an AEP PSO ratepayer, extremely upset with what's happening to her. And most of the Tulsa residents that know and ratepayers that know are all so upset. They want to keep their analog meters. Matter of fact, there should be no smart meters at all to start with anyhow. But anyhow, we'll go into that later. The radiation readings here on my RF analyzer are pretty good. They're 16. That's not bad. For the where I live, it's over 2,000 microwatts up in Owosso there. So what we're going to do is show you the situation here, then we're going to talk with Deborah Jones and see what the situation is with her. So this is the neighborhood, and this is where we're at. I'm going to take you over here and show you the gas meter and the water meter. Remember, all the utilities are transmitting. Maybe the water utility is a little bit behind, but in parts of Tulsa and parts like Broken Arrow, another small area, they've got wireless water meters. So let's go over here and look at the gas meter a second. You can hear the gas meter. This is Oklahoma Natural Gas, and I've been at rate hearings with her, with Margie Alfonso. But this has got a curved top, and on the left-hand side you'll see FCC there, just transmitted. You can hear the thing transmit, and if you look at my meter, when you see it go to 1 on the left, that means it can't read any higher at 200, and that means that it transmit. There it went. It just transmitted. Now you can take your little clock out or whatever. It usually every 15 seconds, and it could be up to 250,000 microwatts every 15 seconds. They're transmitting 24/7 all day long. And the truck, there it went again. Okay, you just saw it go to 1. The truck can be 2 miles away, because I've talked to the young man that drives the truck, and they can read 2 miles away the readings on these meters. There just went again. And so that's very devastating. I told the administrative law judge, Ben Jackson, during those hearings, I said, you know, judge, the radiation doesn't go over and under the house. It goes through houses. It goes through people. It is damaging people's health. And OG&E, Oklahoma Natural Gas, put these in 2010, but they didn't tell anybody about the radiation. Now here's a water utility meter here, Tulsa Water Utility. And if you notice here, there's this metal top, okay? That means there's no transmitter in there. It's got to be a black plastic top, because they got to get the wireless out, because that's how they do it. So that's coming, hopefully. Maybe we'll never get it. Okay, let's go over and look at the analog on Deborah's house a second. And we're going to follow me over here, if you would. Okay, so Deborah's not got a very big house, and it's more dangerous here with this house, because the smaller the house, the more devastating the radiation. It's more concentrated, it's more dense, the radiation. Like, say, here's 12. That's pretty good, but this whole neighborhood now is polluted with smart meters, and it's affecting Deborah's health. Because of the mesh grid network, 14,000 to 190,000 times a day, these things are communicating. That's a court document. So see, Deborah has an analog still. She wants to keep her analog. But you know, we got past this opt-out thing, and she can't afford the $71 a month and $71 upfront fee and $28 a month. And I told her she needs to get the meter off the house, because she's not going to survive this, because she's already sensitive to this radiation. Her doctor told her she was. And so it's going to make it really hard and fast on her, the damage these things do. So we're going to try to take it back to that telephone pole back there. And her nephew is going to do all that. He's a certified electrician. But the trouble is, the cost is too much for that too. And so Deborah's now trying to go back and forth with the Corporation Commission and the utility and you just get the same song and dance we've always gotten. I'll show you the letters that Deborah's got. But you know, this is not a good situation. And in a community where the houses are closer together, and it's devastating. We drove by some apartment complexes here in this area, and it's devastating because they're death traps, because of the concentration of meters, the concentration of people's other electrical wireless things that are in there. But the meters are causing the biggest harm. Okay, let's go over and talk to Deborah now and see what her thoughts are. So we'll go over and we're going to visit with Deborah. She's over here. I was here about a year ago, and I read Deborah's house about a year ago. And so we've been in communication off and on. So here she is here. Deborah, how are you today?
Hi, Joe. I'm hanging in there. How about you, Joe?
Good. This is Deborah Jones. Hi. She's been fighting these goons since this all started. When we had analogs on our homes all these years, we never had any trouble, did we?
Mm-hmm.
So here comes the smart meters, and everybody's screaming out the top of their heads and concerned about damage from all this wireless. And the Corporation Commission and the Attorney General and the utilities just say, this is all okay, there's no problem. They ignore you, even though we filed thousands of pages in PSO's rate case, because I was an intervener in that. So let's go sit down, and we're going to talk a few minutes now. We're here. Okay, Deborah?
Mm-hmm.
Let's go over here.
Turn on my heater.
Why?
Because I think it's an accumulation of this stuff up there in the duct. And I thought
it was mold. So last season she sent somebody out. It wasn't nothing wrong with it. Okay, we're over here with Deborah. And it's a very pleasant day today. It's nice and cool. So we're sitting outside and it's really nice weather. But, you know, I came to Deborah's house about a year ago. And I read Deborah's house, and it's not bad down here as far as radiation. But now that the smart meters are in, they're pulsing all through the neighborhood, and the gas meters are pulsing all through the neighborhood. Deborah can feel that, even though she has an analog still on her house. You know, and so, you know, you kind of look at all this. Deborah has been very involved. She's very concerned because her doctor said she is sensitive to this stuff, and she said she shouldn't be around it, but PSO ignores that. And Deborah's been very, very active. She sent letters, these are letters to the Oklahoma Corporation, to the Attorney General, Scott Pruitt, with a complaint, and they, you know, they shoot the complaint over to the utility, AEP PSO, And it's the same song and dance. So she got her letter back from PSO, from Joanne Stevenson. That's their lawyer who, 4 years ago, you know, when I got in all this, she sent back a letter and said, you know, if you don't, we took the city of Tulsa that gave us a permit, and we took it off with a licensed electrician. And so when they, PSO came to, and the inspector locked it and said, okay, everything's perfect out here. You guys, I'll get the little lock put on there by PSO. So when they came out, we got an overnighted letter from Joanne Stevenson. She's in Oklahoma City, the lawyer. And she said, you know, if you don't change that out, we're going to turn your power off. And they did for 66 days. So I have a little lead on everybody here with all this. But so Joanne's trying to get some answers here. And she gets the same old stuff that they always say. She's not deep into the documents and the studying, so she's going to try to respond to all the things that PSO misrepresents. They just ignore you, these folks. The Corporation Commission ignores you, the PSO ignores you, and the Attorney General ignores you. Okay, so Deborah's been very active. I don't think I've ever seen a lady, be so active as Deborah. Because she knows it harms her. She knows what's getting ready to happen. She's already being harmed by the smart meters in the neighborhood. So Deborah, kind of fill us in about what's been happening now.
Well, I tell you, me and my dog have been sick going on 4 Marches this coming March. And it's just been terrible. That stuff does not discriminate. It don't discriminate against male, female, colors or any of that. The insects are even dying off. So you got to pay attention. People haven't heard of this for some reason, but I've got to pay attention. I don't have a choice. It's just been horrible. Remember, it's not even on my house and made me sick. So it's really something wrong with this picture.
Well, from your neighbors?
Yeah.
Yeah. So how did you first learn about the radiation problem? Did you ever tell me?
I'm trying to remember how. I can't remember how. Might have been something I read somewhere. Might have been something I read because I found your name in a Tulsa.
Yeah, and so then she called me and I came down and we read what's going on. And now it's just kind of escalating and it's getting worse. And I wear this suit just to let you know that I'm sensitive to this radiation. I was in the Marines, I did radar, so I'm real sensitive. It's cumulative. And you just keep getting worse and worse and worse the more you're around it, so you try to eliminate your sources. So Deborah's been going to newspapers. She's been trying to get to lawyers. She's trying to talk to all these different people, and it seems kind of difficult to get people's attention.
Very hard.
To see what's going on. But, you know, it's funny. We had a meeting last week with Bo Collins up in Chelsea. And so, you know, Deborah, to show you that what Deborah is saying is absolutely right, let me read you. This is AEP PSO's opt-out letter of August the 3rd. Let me read it to you. Customers hereby agree to release, hold harmless, and indemnify AEP PSO American Electric Power Company and all of their affiliate companies and any of their officers, directors, employees, and agents from and against losses, liabilities, cost, expenses, suits, actions, and claims, including claims arising out of injury to person or damage to property caused by or in any way attributed to or related to the customer's subsequent installation of a non-standard meter. Hello. Now, do you know any business in the world that will sell you something and give you that paragraph?
To sign away your rights for your life.
Yeah, so you go buy a lawnmower and this guy hands you this to read. And are you going to buy that guy's lawnmower? Let alone a car, Deborah, right?
Correct.
Or here, come live in this house and sign this document. You know, this is insanity, all right? So what Deborah is telling you is absolutely right. But not only that, Deborah is telling you that. But, you know, you look through, like here, remember we showed this at Bo's house. This is Saturday, December 7th, 2013. This is Tulsa World, the article. This is APPSO. Utilities insist smart meters not harmful to humans. So what do they base that on? I mean, show me their documents. I've tried to get documents from them to show what they base all this on. And we go to hearings, which I've been to ad nauseum for the last 4 years, and they sit there and say, well, it's the FCC, you have to go talk to them, and they send you on your merry way, you know, and you call the FCC and say, let me talk to the department that oversees health and problems and all that kind of stuff, and they say, sir, we don't have any departments to deal with health here. This is a licensing agency for frequencies. That's all we do, right? And so it's a shell game that's taking place so they can promote what they're wanting to do. Oklahoma Natural Gas came in first utility, and as far as I know, they didn't get to be able to talk about what radiation they're causing and the super amount of electro pollution they're causing in these neighborhoods and in our homes and to our health. Okay, so we were a little behind the ball with all that back then. So you have people like Dr. Erica Mallory Bly. This is a 79-page document. She has 3 pages. She's a doctor, right? She has 3 pages of health symptoms from the UK. She has 2-hour YouTubes out there. You know, Jerry Flynn, stop the lies, stop the crutch, and stop 50 years of cover-up. Radiation belongs in weapons, not in consumer products and smart meters, all right? And so Lloyd's of London, right? Canceled last year, all wireless radiation. they won't have anything to do with it. They won't cover it. And health problems, they won't do any of those things. And so Flynn, in his like 16-page document, he has a summary statement. He says militaries, he had 26 years in the Canadian military. I mean, and I asked Scott Pruitt one day in Bigsby a year or two ago, I said, Attorney General Mr. Pruitt, who are you going to believe? Are you going to believe the utilities, or are you going to believe the military men that have the expertise in this? And he said, the military guys. Well, I haven't seen him, you know, do anything to help stop any of this. We've been to his offices and talked to like several of his attorneys several times, and nothing happens. Okay, so here's the military guy. Militaries have known for more than 50 years the lethality of each and every frequency within the entire RF spectrum. That today's frequencies on which wireless consumer products and smart meters, did I say smart meters? Okay. are authorized to emit their low-level pulse non-thermal RF radiation are, what does that say, Deborah? It says what? Are
the most.
The, capital, bolded, the most harmful frequencies known to man. That pulsed non-thermal radiation can inflict more harm on people, the human brain, central nervous system, immune system, than can continuous wave radiation, the kind emitted by microwave ovens. Humans can be selectively inflicted with any kind of a host of diseases, illnesses, and harmful effects, even killed by pulsed non-thermal radiation of certain precise frequencies. I think Deborah has an issue, and it's valid here, but they won't listen. That's the problem, okay? What's going on here? I mean, Mr. Flynn has several of those kind of documents that are available, but they won't listen. And so you look at the Bioinitiative Report, 2012, the 29 independent scientists from around the world, and they say there's 1,479 pages. It says evidence for damage to sperm and reproduction, evidence that children are more vulnerable, evidence for fetal and neonatal effects, evidence the effects on autism, and the list goes on. Okay, when I first started all this, back 4 years ago, I knew none of this. And then there's like 24 listed symptoms of being exposed to this stuff. On this page, I had 12 of them, which if I protect myself, that's okay. If I protect myself, I don't have that problem, all right? And if you think those are not enough symptoms, this is a 72 Navy military document that has 2,300 studies of these frequencies we're being affected by. And there's 5 pages of health symptoms. Because back in the 30s, 32, the Germans recognized all this as microwave sickness because they were dealing with all this. And then we kind of stepped up to environmental hypersensitivity. Well, Curtis Bennett in Canada is telling you that radiation belongs in wires, not blasted at us as wireless, so we're being subtly electrocuted. That's why you get sick. That's why even though she doesn't have a meter, she's still being subtly electrocuted because of all the smog is inundating these neighborhoods with the gas. Water's not here yet, but the smart meters are here, right?
Right.
So I mean, it's kind of a problem. And then, you know, they have AEP putting out trifold folders that are, where it talks about the meters are misinformation, and they're telling you cell phones are far more powerful than their smart meters. They even say in this document, if you're using microwatts per meter squared, their meters are transmitting at 400,000 microwatts. Okay? So we did a YouTube on it. Ron will put the YouTube up there for you here in a minute. And he'll show you, we read 12 microwatts to 90 microwatts when the phone was on. It wasn't 1 million to 10 million microwatts. So there's a lot of misinformation, and that's what they send out to the average ratepayer and expects her to debate with them the misinformation that they caused all the issues. But that's okay, because the lawsuits are coming. This is a Virginia lawsuit, Donna Kinsey, $3.5 million lawsuit, October the 10th. Now, if you took the utilities name off of here in Virginia and you put AEP PSOs in here, you could almost use this to file suit against PSO, AEP PSO. This document is August 8th, Dr. Marino. He spent his life, his career, studying this kind of radiation. And so he's telling you this is involuntary human experimentation. So they're telling you this stuff is not safe. It, I mean, it's bad stuff. And it just, I mean, there was an article by Olga Sheehan. She did an article a few months ago. It was 25 pages. And she lived in Vancouver, and she sent a letter to the mayor because they're putting all this wireless in there, and she was asking all these questions. And she had a tumor in her brain they had to have cut out. She's had to be run out of Canada now, Vancouver, because of all the wireless. She can't handle it. Deborah has nowhere to go. You got someplace else to go that I know?
I wish I did.
She can't jump a plane and go someplace. Or go move someplace. This is where she's at.
That's totally wrong anyway. You can't do people like that.
That's right. It's wrong. This whole thing is wrong.
Totally wrong.
And I was sharing with Ron as we were around the corner. You know, there's an apartment complex down the way there on the corner. Mm-hmm. Those are death traps because of all the wireless. The meters are like 10, 15, 20 meters to a complex. I've been in those things. I've read those places. And they're extremely dangerous, and people are getting very sick. But when they get sick, they don't know what to do. They don't know what's causing it.
They think they just have cancer.
Yeah, or the doctor says, well, you're just getting old.
Or you're stressed out, that's why you had a stroke.
Yeah, or a heart attack, right? But this stuff causes those things. Pacemakers shouldn't be around any of this. You can watch Take Back Your Power. There's lots of YouTube's documentaries out there you need to watch so you can kind of see some of these things. We've done about 17 YouTubes trying to help people understand. But this lady, see, it says heads in the sand, pie in the skies, Health Canada, and she's from Canada, okay? But the thing is, you can apply that to us because the standard came from Safety Code 6 to the United States. And that's the standard they use. And what I'll kind of read to you in a minute. Health Canada denies the proven dangers of microwave radiation. So here you see all these people with their heads in the sand. That's the utilities and the Corporation Commission and the Attorney General. They're ignoring us. They don't want to hear about it. Okay, so it talks about from Wi-Fi, cell phones, cordless phones, and smart meters, a reality check by Olga Sheehan, and this is November the 7th. That's not too many days ago, today's 13th, right? So she just hit this with the internet just a few days ago. And she's telling you, in June 26th, I submitted a 25-page report, no safe place. That's what you were saying, right?
Correct.
Where are you gonna go? This is a $1,700 suit I have on. It's 50 dBD protection. That's unheard of. And this is out of the UK. Most of the stuff in the U.S. is 20. So I have to have this on. Well, I've got two doctor's letters in my pocket and an attorney's letter that I carry. I've been to the state legislature wearing this suit. I have to wear it or I can't be out in this radiation. And people don't realize it, but as they're driving down the road, they go past cell towers. The cell towers are coming right through the walls in their homes, and they're being damaged. The smart meters do the exact same thing. You put a smart meter on a person's home, it's coming right through their house. You can go turn the breaker off at the box, and you can go inside the house, take my meter, walk through the house. You can hear the radiation coming through the house. And the reason they do that is because they're wanting to communicate with all your new Energy Star appliances. Because now your appliances are going to be radiating you off and on all day long. And then the smart meter is going to be communicating back and forth with all that. So, you know, this lady listen, this is kind of one of her sentences in this opening statement. You have refused to accept acknowledgement or act upon the science evidence of the harm caused by wireless radiation, but you will soon be forced to do so. Continue to deny and distort the facts, and you will create the most costly epidemic of illness ever. It will require guts and integrity to admit your negligence and tackle the problem now before it escalates out of control. All right? And we're just about there now. Right?
Right.
Okay. So you can go on through this, and there's, remember, she talks about, we were talking about the plastic head. Let me see if I can just pick that up real quick for us. I'll tell you about the head in a second, but here's one more paragraph that really kind of nails the whole thing down to what's happening here. If you continue to deny the scientific proof, bioeffects of non-ionizing RF microwave radiation in our environment, to which all Canadians, which you can just say Americans, are being subjected without their informed consent, because nobody knows it's happening. They don't even know what a smart meter is, right?
Right.
You go out and you talk to people and they don't know.
They don't know.
They don't know. And beyond their control, constituting criminal negligence, reckless endangerment, violation of countless human constitutional rights, and unconscionable dereliction of your sworn duty. As elected public officials, you will pay the price. You claim your claims of due diligence, ongoing research, protection of public safety, etc., are so transparent, so self-serving, that they make a mockery of evidence-based decision-making. Your claim that non-thermal-based Safety Code 6, that's the plastic head, is protective, is a political travesty of unprecedented proportion and a disgrace to your public office, tasked as you are with protecting our health. As an incident of EMF-induced ill health explodes out of control, healthcare and other infrastructures will soon be overwhelmed. Pensions funds will dry up. More teachers will resign or be incapacitated. Children will suffer irreversible biological effects. Hospitals will be overrun. Mortgages will go unpaid. The government itself will be brought to its knees by a multitude of lawsuits. They're coming. That's why insurance.
Lloyd's of London.
Lloyd's of London. Thanks, Ron. Appreciate that. It's just escalating out of control. That's what Deborah, we're just sitting here saying. When her utility bills keep going up and everything keeps going up and people keep getting sick, how are you going to live in your house?
You won't be able to. Landlords are not going to have homes anymore because the utilities is going sky high. And nobody's going to be able to afford them in the first place. So landlords, you might want to watch out just for that point.
The science is already there. 23,000 some studies show it. I mean, the doctors are there, the science is there, the military guys are telling you all this, but they keep ignoring us. They keep ignoring everybody. And so, something's going to have to stop. Something's going to have to be done. And so, when we were at Bose the other day, we came up with this kind of explanation of what we want. There should be an immediate moratorium on AEP PSO's smart meter program in Oklahoma, because wireless non-ionizing non-thermal pulsed man-made microwave radiation is being emitted from AEP PSO's digital smart meter operating and assaulting ratepayers in their homes. This is a criminal action with malice and aforethought to cause injury or death to the people when AEP PSO force installation digital smart meters on their homes. What AEP PSO is conducting is involuntary human experimentation on their ratepayers. All opt-out ratepayers should be allowed to keep their analog mechanical meters, and if these analog meters have already been replaced by a non-standard smart meter, red face meter, AMR with transmitter pulled, their analog meter should be replaced immediately. The current ratepayers that have been had forced installation of the Blue Face Smart Meter AMI should have their transmitter cards pulled immediately, and those meters read by a real live meter reader to determine AEP PSO's billing charges. So we're listening to Jerry Flynn, who says none of this radiation is safe, man-made, and even the smallest amount is dangerous. But yet Deborah gets a letter from the utility saying, well, it's just a little bit of radiation. And besides, we've been using these meters for 13 years now in other places. Well, where did they get the permission? From, did they go to the Corporation Commission and ask for permission 13 years ago to start using these? So where's their studies? In the lawsuit for $3.5 million, the utility said, well, they're safe and we're gonna study the health issues. Well, they never came back with any studies on the health issues. They're experimenting on us. That's why PSO, AEP PSO came to WASO and they said, we're having a pilot program. That's experimentation, right?
Mm-hmm.
We're getting sick. There's more and more people getting sick. And as we get the information out to the public, okay, then the lawsuits are coming. Okay, we're working on the lawsuits, all right? So this thing is real. And so these people are going to be made accountable. Look at Ogoshehan, what she's saying in her letter. This stuff's out of control. They're being ignored for the profits of industry. And they're ignoring people's health. They've been ignoring it since 1932, when all these people got sick and they called it microwave sickness.
Ooh.
Right?
Wow.
So what do you think we ought to do?
Well, for one, I keep thinking, isn't there a law on the books that prevents somebody from doing something that could cause bodily harm to a human being?
Well,
isn't there some kind of law on the books?
Yeah, I think there is, but you know, I'm not the lawyer guy. But you know, I tried to share with some people, and I may have shared this with the Attorney General's lawyer. I said, you know, this is Oklahoma. So if somebody comes through my front door to harm my family, I can use deadly force, right?
Stand my ground,
right? Stand my ground, right? Because you're gonna damage my family. So now tell me the difference in putting a smart meter on my house or having a cell tower right next door, and all this radiation is coming through your house. We can measure it. We can measure it. That's what Ogoshehan is saying. How do you measure this stuff? I mean, there's all this radiation taking place out there. How do you keep up with it? How do you measure it? How do you know how much there is? And so, you know, here's another quote she has. Our environment currently has about 10 million times more RF radiation than it did in the 60s. If this environment is safe, we're talking about 15 to 25,000 papers in peer-reviewed science journals all being wrong. That has never happened before. That comes from Olio Johannesson over there. But there's one other thing. You can't measure this stuff. That's the trouble. Okay. there is no protection from wireless radiation. How do you protect yourself? Well, this is one way. You know, and I guess you could wear lead aprons like they do in the hospitals, but that's ionizing. This is non-ionizing, but it'll help protect you. There is no monitoring or testing of EMF levels. You can have, I mean, how many cell towers can you have? Go to antennasearch.com. There is Seneca Scott, he's a state rep in north of TU. He had 215 cell towers and 900 antennas in a 4 mile radius of his house.
Wow.
So if you can get further out, rurally, you'll have less radiation. See, but where you live, you know, we did an antenna search here.
Okay? Plenty of trees.
There are no limits to the radiation emitted. I mean, there can be all these devices out there just going at it, like water meters and gas meters. Who's monitoring all this out here? There is no escape or any way to protect one's own health. There is no safety or respect for individual choices. I mean, this is totally out of control, and it's getting more out of control by the day. And so it needs to be stopped. I went to the Corporation Commission, to the state legislature, January the 8th, 2013, with information and documentation when my meter, trying to show them, you know, when I learned all this was happening in Owosso, I thought they'd want to hear. They didn't. They don't want to hear any of it. I told them, 4 years ago? I stood there, January the 3rd, before Bob Anthony, who is ignoring his responsibility. So is Dana Murphy. Todd Hyatt, maybe, I'm not sure on that. But I stood there in that hearing room, and I said, this is my third anniversary to be fighting this fight. And I met you first across the hall about 20 feet away. That was 3 years ago. We're telling you, you keep ignoring us, right?
Right.
They ignore you, right?
Totally.
Okay, so we're just kind of letting people know kind of what's happened. This is all legitimate. There's documentation that shows it. The science is there. The military people are there. The plastic head thing is there. You know, they took a plastic, they had a 6'2", 220 pound military guy. They took a plastic mold of his head and they stuck a meat probe thermometer, cut a hole in the plastic head, put some simulated brain fluid in there, put a cell phone against his ear, which wasn't connected to the network. It was just a cell phone sitting there. And they said if that cell phone didn't heat that thermometer over 1 degree in 6 minutes, it was safe. That's no biology. There's no science to that. It's a cooking class. You can do that in your kitchen.
Wow.
You know, this is damaging. Now science has caught up. And so we need to pay attention. But the only people that are going to stop it is the public. The corporation commissioners are not doing their job. Okay?
They should be jailed.
Right.
Attempted homicide.
That's what we're saying in these documents. Okay? That's criminal actions against us. Okay? And so, you know, where's the Attorney General? Where's he trying to stop this? Where's our state legislators? I've been bringing these newspapers. I've published in the Banner newspaper. This is 9 different newspapers that I took to them the last week in May, because that was the end of their session. They start from February 1 to the end of May. And I've published now last week, 133 articles trying to help people understand all this. I take them to the state legislature, pick them up in Choteau, which is east of Tulsa, and drive them all the way to the state capitol and hand them out to the legislators. They ignore you.
Well, the stuff don't discriminate.
Right. It's an equal opportunity killer.
That's right.
That's right. So we need to get involved here. We need to kind of start helping each other and getting involved here so we can, you need to let your corporation commissioners hear about it. Scott Pruitt hear about it. You need to call them. The state legislature is getting ready to go back in session February the 1st. So they'll be writing legislation. So we need to get in there and stop this stuff. We need to go to court with AEP PSO and file against them so we can stop what they're doing. Because the documents are here now, and so we need to do something, right?
Right. Gotta
okay,
do
you,
something.
You all be the, you make the decisions. You need to do your research. My number is 918-274-8111. Call me, and I'll help you try to send you stuff or whatever. Or if you have any questions, I'll be happy to help you. Right, Deborah?
That's right.
Okay, it's all yours.